Hello all. Welcome to the program, Know Your Government by New IAS, an initiative where we pick a government scheme, elaborate on its content, and is followed by a question which is in line with the UPSC pattern. Today, we will look into a scheme which is known as Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. The Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram is a scheme which is implemented by the Ministry of Minority Affairs, a scheme which is implemented by the Ministry of Minority Affairs. The key purpose of this program is to improve the socio-economic conditions of the minorities as well as to provide basic amenities to improve the quality of life of those people. Two key purposes: one is to improve the socio-economic conditions of the minorities as well as to provide basic amenities to improve the quality of life of the minorities is the key objective of Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Now, this would be related to the creation of infrastructure mainly in the sectors of education, health and skill development. So, three key areas or segments wherein which this scheme is focusing upon would involve: one is education of the minority communities, two, health of the minority communities, and third one is related to their skill development. So, education, health and skill development. And apart from this, they are also focusing upon other innovative schemes which is taking care of the social as well as the economic developmental part and the living conditions of the minority communities. Now, previously there was a program which was known as multi-sectoral developmental program. Multi-sectoral developmental program. This program has been restructured and has been named by the name of Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. So, it was the multi-sectoral developmental program which has been restructured to Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Now, this program is now planned to be implemented till the period of 2019-20 or during the remaining period of the 14th Finance Commission is when the government is planning to go ahead with this scheme. This will be implemented as a centrally sponsored scheme. So, Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram will be implemented as a centrally sponsored scheme by the government. Now, another key feature of this one is whatever be some of the key entities or the things, you know, which are left uncovered under the multi-sectoral developmental program, this program will also aid or assist in the developmental of those aspects as well. So, those areas which were left incomplete under the multi-sectoral developmental program, that too will be taken care under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Now, this has used the socio-economic as well as the basic amenities. Those data has been picked up from the census value from the census of 2011. So, the census of 2011 was acting as the data point to pick the elements of socio-economic as well as the basic amenities need in our nation. Then, to ensure the holistic developmental of the minority communities, understand this point that 80% of the resources under this program, 80% of the resources under this program would be utilized for projects related to education, health and skill development. And among in that, they are giving close to 30 to 40% will be earmarked for the creation of assets and also for facilities for women and the girls. So, specific focus in this program is given for the development of women as well as for the girls across our nation is one of the key feature of Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Then, so under Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram, the communities notified as minority communities under Section 2C of the National Commission for Minorities Act of 1992, National Commission for Minorities Act of 1992, those communities which has been listed as minorities under this act are the communities which has been given focus under this Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Now, at present, close to 6 communities, those would involve Muslims, the Sikhs, the Christians, the Buddhists, the Zoroastrians, as well as the Jains. These have been notified as the minority communities under this act. So the communities which has been notified as minorities under this act would involve: one is the Muslim community, two is the Sikh community, third is the Christian community, Buddhist, four, Zoroastrians or the Parsis as five, and Jains as the sixth community. Then, the parameters for identification of the minority concentration areas, because definitely this is a program wherein which the minorities developmental has been taken care of. So, the areas wherein which the minorities concentration is there are the areas wherein which the program needs to give specific focus to, and that has been identified again through the data from Census 2011. The details of the backwardness parameters applied for the identification of such areas are mainly two, or two parameters has been listed to identify the backwardness areas wherein with the minority concentration part is there. What were those? One is the religion specific socio-economic indicators at the district, block or town level. I'll repeat it once more. One parameter is the religion specific socio-economic indicators at the district, block or town level, and the second parameter is something which is the basic amenities indicators at the district, block or town level. Now, regarding the religion specific focus for socio-economic indicators, they are taking care about the literacy rate, the female literacy rate, work participation rate, as well as the female work participation rate. So that means literacy rate in a particular religion, then female literacy rate in a particular religion, then work participation rate, as well as the female work participation rate, are the four parameters which has been coming under the religion specific indicators. Whereas in terms of the basic amenities, they are focusing upon: one is the percentage of household with pakka walls, percentage of household with pakka walls, then percentage of household with safe drinking water, percentage of household with electricity, and percentage of household with latrine facility. The basic amenities like pakka walls, drinking water facility, electricity, as well as the latrine facility are the things which has been taken into consideration under this parameter. Then the area for implementation is something, you know, which we again need to focus upon. The area for implementation of this program, what they have done is, they, in respect of the socio-economic or the basic parameters or the basic amenity parameters, I'll repeat it once more, in respect of either socio-economic parameters or the basic amenity parameters or both, if a particular region is flaring below the national average, that region is something which needs to be given specific focus up into. And that would involve: one is backward minority concentration blocks, those blocks region wherein which the minorities has been concentrated but their developmental part is less than the national average is one area which has been picked for developmental under the scheme. Second is the backward minority concentration towns. So first one was the block level, second one was, again, you know, they are focusing upon the town level with the same parameter. Then backward minority concentration district headquarters, in those district headquarters where the backward minority concentration are prominent, that needs to be taken care of and has been given a specific area of implementation under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Then is the backward clusters of minority concentration villages, backward clusters of minority concentration villages. The four key parameters would involve: backward minority concentration blocks, backward minority concentration towns, backward minority concentration district headquarters, as well as backward clusters of minority concentration villages. Now, in terms of this minority concentration villages, what they are doing is, in a state or union territory, the villages having minimum of 25% of minority population, but they are not identified under the previous defined parameters. The key differentiating aspect is, minorities should follow close to 25% of the population in a concentration village cluster, and they are not identified in the previously defined parameters. Those are the regions which are coming under the parameter of backward cluster for minority concentration villages. Then the implementing agencies of this program would involve both state PSUs, the state governments, as well as from a central governmental support, and that would also include the state governmental agencies like DRDA, that is district rural developmental agencies, then CPSAs, that is Central Public Sector Enterprises. So on a ground level, this has been implemented both with the support of both the state government as well as the central government, so that the program has been making a good impact to the minority community. Now, another key aspect of this program is they are monitoring the success and progress of these programs in a very effective and thorough manner as well. They have got an online module along with geotagging facility, which is properly helping the government missionaries to understand that the development which has been made related to the minority developmental areas is one of the key development. And second thing is a provision to bring all implementing agencies under public finance management system. So all implementing agencies brought under a single public finance management system, so that or to ensure that the financial part is also being taken care in a very neat and clear manner, is also one of the key feature of Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. With this background, we will see a question based on this. With reference to Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram, which of the following statements given below is or are correct? Statement 1. The erstwhile multi-sectoral developmental program has been restructured and renamed as Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. As we have already seen, it was this multi-sectoral developmental program which has been restructured and renamed as Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram, which is making the first statement correct. Now, the second one is it will be implemented as a centrally sponsored scheme. Yes, we have already seen that Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram, though there is a state government element also there involving in terms of implementing this scheme will be implemented as a centrally sponsored scheme. So, which is making statement 1 and statement 2 correct. So, which is giving the answer as C, both 1 and 2. Thank you so much.